So after a magnificent presentation by Dr. Prashant, he has the advantage that he's been using the system. I've attended his OT and I appreciate the beauty of what we see on the screen when he's using the system. However, I have to defend what the conventional IP still gives us. I would like to thank AOS for having given me this opportunity. Now, looking at the evolution of ophthalmic surgery, especially vitreous surgery, it paralleled the technological additions to the surgical microscope. Tiltable eyepieces, great depth of field, good resolution of the eyepieces, coupled with XY coupling of the microscope, has taken us to this day. Visualization is the key, and as systems have evolved over time to the present day, non-contact visualization systems, we have reached the state of art VR surgery today. What the system which Dr. Prashant said, it uses digital images from the image of our old microscope. It manipulates and processes the image and magnifies it on the screen. Different systems use different technologies in which Polaroid glasses can be used to separate the images for the two eyes, leading to depth perception. However, in this process, there is a conflict between convergence and accommodation of the surgeon. Some surgeons don't get adjusted to this abnormal binocular vision if there is especially too much disparity between the right and the left eyes. Now, coming to surgical performance, most of the studies have even today shown that the gold standard is still the eyepieces with the conventional microscope to which it is compared. In some studies, they have shown decrease in operative fluency, which I may discount as a learning curve. But all studies emphasize that resolution is surely better with a microscope. With the new system, magnification is used to overcome this drawback. Most of the cases where comparison was done, surgical time was the same, success rate is the same, the complication rate is too the same in both different procedures. However, the drawbacks which have been mentioned in the studies say that there is difficult logistics, cost is exorbitant, assistants may feel some discomfort, and especially we should be aware of sudden head movement by the patient. The system, different systems which are available here, they are both active as passive. In the active system, it is said to be less strenuous onto the eye, but all the systems which are optically good for the surgeon, they are very good for the anterior and the mid vitreous cavity. As we go close to the peripheral retina, or as we go too close to the retina, there may be depth perception difficulties faced by some surgeons. I presume those surgeons who have a good accommodation amplitude have no difficulty in using this system, but it may not suit all surgeons. Virgin accommodation conflicts do cause visual fatigue and discomfort, and it may be worsening pre-existing exophorias. Incomplete separation of both eye images, especially in the passive 3D systems, may be causing this difficulty. So the main complaints were difficulty of anticipating movement of patient during scleral indentation. Opacities in the anterior segment may be magnified in view in this system. And in some surgeons have complained of nausea and dizziness, especially with prolonged laser photocoagulation. Different systems have started adapting to this sort of difficulty, where head-mounted systems have been manufactured by Sony. And there is a different device which is manufactured by a company in Israel, which also is head-mounted, and they also don't use a conventional operating microscope. These head-mounted devices allow the surgeon to see through the lower part of this device onto the operating field. There is a greater depth perception and spatial orientation and a lesser learning curve as described by those who use them. Now coming to the machine as such, as we've seen the technology evolve, it is in the early majority, which we see, maybe even less than that. And if it doesn't sustain at the cost offered to the customer, it may die out slowly. The technology is good, but whether it is to be bought by the majority and it is usable and cost efficient is the question. Thank you.